The yellow line here describes the spine angle of the golfer. What we see is a rather rounded back, like this. We'd like to see that spine being on a straight line. A straight axle works better than a bent axle. Let's get that everything out of the way. Let's redraw in now the shaft angle. That's the swing plane. And we'll put a little circle around the golfer's head. We'd like his head to stay inside that circle. Now let's take the swing back partway. What we'll see here is that the club is going a little bit to the inside, but more importantly, it's pretty well shut. In other words, it's still facing, the club face is facing down to the golf ball. That tells you that you're not letting your hands extend in the direct manner and that you're pulling the club in too close to your body. The face of the club now should be pointing up. Should be more that way. Instead, you can see that it's going way off over here like that. So we want to get rid of that. We want to let the club rotate on the way up like it's designed to do. The good news is, and the other bad thing is, see how far his head is lifted? See how his head is inside the circle? Now he's lifting his head up. It's not called an upswing. It's called a backswing. And we want to swing backwards by rotating. Also, you'll notice he's getting a lot of lifting going on his left heel, how it's coming way up off the ground. It's really hard to do that and maintain your posture at the same time. So what he's done is he's pulled completely up and out of the shot. Now the good news is when he gets to here, he's got the club shaft on a good line right there. And you notice the face of the club and the lead arm are parallel. And the lead arm is also parallel to the swing plane. That's a good thing. Now if he can reroute the club back down between those two yellow lines, he's going to be in a pretty good position. We'd like to see the head of the club go actually down and below that line and then back to the ball. We'll see if it does that. Let's get rid of those two lines here. The other thing we want to see is that he rotates his right knee towards his left knee and doesn't push it out. So as we start down, you'll see that what happens is the first move is out and away. Instead of bringing the trail elbow or right elbow down, that right elbow needs to come down on this line right there and get down off his hip, more of a throwing motion. Way he's throwing now, it's like he's going to throw the ball straight into the ground. And the idea is we want to throw the ball in the same direction we want the ball, golf ball to go. So his elbow is going to stay behind him. He's going to move his head, still raising up. Now his head is completely outside the line. You can see that. He's way up and out of his shot. The club head is well above the top yellow line instead of below the bottom yellow line. That's a coming over the top move, which will have a tendency to move the ball from a left to right or straight to right arc. You can see there, now his right knee is moving not towards the left knee, but actually towards the golf ball. We don't want it to do that. He's in a pretty good position there with his arms. His head isn't too bad. He's got a little closer to the ball, you can see. But he cuts across it, or he swings across the ball instead of out towards the target line instead of that way. You can see that he swings in. Instead of coming out to in, instead of coming in to out, he's going out to in. There the ball is cutting wildly across his body. That's what we need to work on. Keeping the right heel on the ground a little longer so that what brings the right heel off the ground is the rotation of the hip. That's this rotation here. So we turn the hips a lot, which then rotates the right knee towards the left knee and pulls the heel up rather than lifting the heel up. Comes to a pretty decent finish. Back on plane again. So while in all it's a fairly mechanical swing, mechanically sound swing, he's got a few little issues to work on that are very important. The angle of the spine, obviously, the position of the head, and his ability to use his feet and stay connected to the ground. Now this is after a 6-week layoff, so I'm going to say kudos, pretty good swing.